Ah, dear, yes, sir. Do you know, I was looking at Peter Casey there and it got me thinking about the said predicament he found himself in. And, you know, I was thinking those people that are lucky enough to get a house, and depending on what they did for a living or what their parents did, maybe what would they be looking for along with the house? Maybe the farming community, if you're one of them, maybe you'd look for 100 acres and maybe 100 head of cattle, or if sheep was a thing you were into, or pigs or whatever, maybe you'd look for some of them. And maybe the fishing community, maybe they could look and have a lake dug out in the backyard and a boat upon it, and maybe a fishing rod as well, and an outboard motor maybe. Or if you came from a line of post office workers, well maybe then you'd look for the post van and a post box as well in the garden. The health workers, well, sure, they'd want maybe a defibrillator put on the gable wall. They'd probably need a stethoscope and a few bandages as well to help them. And if you came from a line of teachers, or your mother and father were a teacher, maybe a blackboard, a duster, and maybe a meter ruler for them. The guards, they'd probably want a lock-up cell in the garage for them. And the builders would probably look for some scaffold, and they'd need some cement mix or a trowel, and a shovel or that. And so then the poor publicans couldn't be forgotten about. They'd have to get a beer garden, probably. And sure, they'd want music every Saturday night as well. Do you know, you'd have to be thinking about everybody, because everybody has to be treated the same, and there can be no exceptions made. So that's just my thought on it, whatever you think yourself, sure, I don't know.